Any Christians believe that?
I'm not concerned at all.
Ask him.
I'm not speaking.
Okay.
You ask him.
Is there any Christian here?
Unfortunately, yeah.
Well, come. Well, come on. Come on.
You actually believe Adam? You actually believe Adam is made of the same substance as God?
God says, "I created man in my own image, my friend."
You know what that means?
Oh, you're gonna give me the meaning now after what I said?
Hold on. We have a hadith. Adam is created in the image of God.
The Bible says.
But then from the Islamic perspective, we have a very clear definition.
Uh-huh.
Because you see, when somebody makes something, for example, if you were working in a factory, you would have a mold from which you make other items.
Yes.
For example, these covers.
Yeah.
Maybe they might have used a mold to print this cover in that shape.
Yeah.
So that mold belongs to the factory.
Yes.
Similarly, in the image of God,
uh-huh,
means the image
belong to God.
Or the blue frame
belong to God.
Brilliant.
That's clever.
However, what Adam is made of is not what the substance, what Allah is made of.
So hold on. Can
but
I give
he says his God is made of the same substance as that of Adam, which is a complete utter nonsense.
No, wait, listen.
I don't think any Christian even believes that.
Yes, it is, God. Can I come in now?
Yes, God.
Right. You said the same mold belong to God.
Sorry,
the same mold,
yeah, the blueprint
belongs to God. This is exactly what the gospel is all about. The frame belongs to God, but he decided to deposit himself in his own humanity to represent him on the earth to redeem mankind. How about that? So he's using the blueprint.
So he's created, you're
saying? He's using the blueprint of himself.
Created, that means he's created.
Yeah.
Okay, Jesus is created according to this guy.
Listen, no.
I don't think he actually believes what he believes.
In the sense of creation,
exactly,
begin with Adam.
Yes.
Jesus.
Hold
on. Jesus came from a Virgin Mary. It's like you and I are technically created. You might say no. Why? But we're created through the form of a human. Woman. It's the same process of creation is now passed on to us today, having children, woman having children. The same form. That is creation. But in the form of passing through a woman. Same thing. Still creation.
I don't disagree.
Right.
So Jesus was created.
That's what I'm trying to say. Because he came from a woman and creation began with humanity, because he was humanity and come from a woman, yes, you can term it as being created. Yes.
Adam is better than him.
Huh?
Adam is better person than him. He didn't need no woman.
No, Jesus is better because Jesus come. Hold on, Jesus come from no.
From a woman.
No, listen. Jesus has the spirit within himself from the divine source. In other words, God is a spirit, and all humanity have a percentage of that spirit in them when we accept Christ.
Percentage of God's spirit in us. So you're saying God is in you?
Yes, when I accept him, yes, he's become a part of me. Yes, he's in me.
So you believe God is everywhere?
Yeah, of course.
Do you believe God is in hell?
God goes anywhere he wants.
Is he in hell?
Anywhere he wants to go.
Hell.
Anywhere.
Let's say yes or no.
He can go anywhere he wants.
Is he in hell?
No. I'm gonna tell you. Hold on. Let me explain. You know why God is not in hell?
You said anywhere.
No, you know.
Three times he
hold
said
on.
Three
you know
times.
Why God is not in hell?
You said everywhere.
No. Do you know why God is not in hell?
You said he's everywhere.
Because God is a representative of light, and where he is, which is light, darkness cannot be. Hell is where darkness is. God is light. If he goes to hell, hell is no more hell.
Three times you said yes.
You hear me?
Everywhere.
Listen to me. Listen, he asked me, hello. Listen, cameraman, listen to me. He's asking me if God can go to hell. If God goes to hell, hell will no more be hell. Hell will be more heaven. Because God's power, when he goes to hell, transform hell into heaven.
Where does he say in the Bible?
So you agree with me that God is not heaven?
This is amazing, God is. When he goes to hell, hell is no more hell. Because hell is darkness.
So you are
when God, which is light, goes to hell, hell is no more hell.
So ladies and gentlemen, listen to this gentleman earlier. Earlier I asked him, is God everywhere? And he said yes.
Yes, he is.
Three times he said yes.
Yes, that's right.
Then I asked him, is he in hell? And he said no. So he doesn't know what everywhere is.
What do you mean?
You said
God is light, he cannot dwell in darkness. Darkness is hell.
Is hell part of everything?
If God goes to hell, I said again, God is light, he can't go into darkness. If he goes into darkness, the darkness which is hell cannot contain him. He's going to become God in that hell.
Is hell?
So that means there no more hell exists.
I think you're trying to run away from there.
No, you completely misunderstood the point. The point is this, is hell part of everywhere?
God is light. If he goes to hell, hell is no more hell. Because hell is darkness.
By the way,
God is light. When he goes to hell, Ellis in existence anymore. Because guess what? He's gone there.
That's not everywhere.
So he's taking light to hell, 1 minute, and transform hell into light. Go on now.
Okay. Is hell part of everywhere?
Yes, so he's everywhere.
Okay, he's God everywhere.
Omniscient.
Okay, so he's in hell as well then. Thank you.
No, he's not. No, no, let
make
listen.
Up your mind.
If he goes to hell, is part of everywhere. He missed my point.
And if God is in hell, sorry, is everywhere, then he should be in hell as well.
If you're saying
hell is not part of everywhere, then yes, you might have a point. But because you say hell is part of everywhere,
if he goes to hell, if God goes to hell, hell is no longer in existence.
But your God went to hell when he died, remember?
Listen,
when Jesus died, he went to hell.
That's what I'm saying. But if he stayed there, hell would not exist anymore.
No, but when he went to hell, he didn't exist.
Listen, bro.
When Jesus went to hell, did it exist?
Yes, that's right.
You said when God goes in hell, it won't be hell anymore.
No. What I'm trying to say to you, what you're talking Jesus, not God. God divine, if he goes to hell, hell doesn't exist anymore. He cannot dwell in hell. He's light. He can't dwell in darkness.
He did go to hell.
He can't dwell in darkness.
And hell is still existing.
What?
So you are wrong. Jesus, when he died, the first place he went to was Hades. Hades is hell. And you, according to you, if God goes in hell, hell will not be hell anymore.
Exactly.
But it's still hell.
What?
He still hasn't realized, has he?
Any more questions?
I don't think
Do you want any more questions?
Yes, the question is this.
Yeah.
Can God have a God?
Sorry?
Can God have a God?
No.
Did Jesus have a God?
No.
Why did Jesus say, I go to my God in John 20:17?
What you need to understand in context.
Give me the context.
He's literally saying, look, what? As we read in the text earlier, he came in the form of a servant. In other words.
So in other words, he's not God.
Can I break it down, sir?
Yeah, go on.
This guy is the owner of the company. You are his son. He is in charge of 90% of the shares of the company. You only the son. He said to you, look, I'm giving you 50% of the share, right? But he owned 90. He can't really give you 50%. So he's pretty much saying, all right, I'm going to keep 50 and give you 30.
What's that going to do?
Hold on a minute. I'm breaking it down to you. So listen to what I'm trying to say. So in this...
Do you remember my question?
Wait. In this, it is showing you here...
He's sharing.
...that what he is the owner, but he took it... He said to you, I am the owner, but what I'm going to do, I'm going to give you power over the company. But you are going to... You are inheritance of the company in case he is not around.
So if he gives me 50%,
hold on.
Who's going to be the owner now?
No. Wait.
If he had 90, if you give me 50, I become your owner.
Exactly.
Is that what happened to Jesus? He became the owner of his father?
Let me finish, no man.
That's
the
worst example.
Let me finish.
Where did these guys come from?
Let me finish. So, but what Jesus did now, he took the form of a servant. So you are the father, you give your son 50%. In other words, instead of him saying, I have power over the company now, you as a son say, Daddy, because you are always owner of the company, even though you give me percent, I'm going to go below you. Amazing. Hey,
why
my
is that
God is amazing. Let me tell you something.
You
my God is amazing.
Do you remember
any question you want, I'll give it to you.
Do you remember my question?
Because I heard your question.
What was my question?
Just explain. If God can have God.
Yes.
Yeah, that's what
did Jesus have a God?
No.
So Jesus lied in the Bible?
No. Show me where it is.
John 20:17.
Read it. John 20:17.
Oh my God.
I like to look at
educate them about their own Bible.
No.
Sorry.
Disgusting.
John what?
John chapter 20, verse 17.
Right. John 20. No man, I speak to myself. John 20.
Remember, he said, God cannot have a God.
No.
John 20, verse 17.
17.
Right. Jesus said unto her, touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my Father, but go to my brethren.
Carry on.
And say unto them, I ascend unto my Father and your Father and my God and your God.
When he said my God, what does it mean?
Because he takes the form of a servant. We have already established.
So you're saying Jesus during his ministry was only a servant?
That's right.
He was never God.
What I'm saying, God is a spirit, sir.
Is he God or not? Tell me that.
I'm answering the question. God is a spirit.
All I want to know is,
hold on.
Is Jesus God on earth or not during his ministry?
Listen, you can't get one answer for everything. I'm going to explain it to you.
Okay,
God is a spirit, my friend. When Jesus came and walking on the earth, he had the supreme authority of his father. Once he on earth, he he denounces his heavenly office and take the form of a servant. So when he said, I pray to my Father, it means that he's praying to the greater source, which is the Spirit of God.
You still haven't answered my question. Was Jesus fully God or not?
No.
So you don't
believe, no making sense.
So you don't believe Jesus is God?
No, Jesus is God, but not fully God on earth. That's what I'm saying.
So how much percent was he God on earth?
50-50.
50-50?
That's right.
What kind of a God is that?
What do you mean, what kind of God is that?
How many gods are there?
Should I break it down?
How many gods are there?
No, should I explain it?
After you answer my question.
Should I explain it? No.
After you answer my question.
No, because what?
It's a very simple question.
I want to answer your question, but you're jumping on, that's why I can't.
How many gods do you believe in?
One God.
Is that one God, 100% God?
No. God? What do you mean? Sorry, I missed that question. Sorry, I'm so sorry.
I asked you how many gods do you believe in?
One God.
Is that one God, 100% God?
Yes.
Okay, is that God Jesus? Yes. What happened?
In the sin.
He's just thinking, that's a good sign.
No.
No, good, let him think. Good.
In the sense,
is Jesus 100% God?
Hold on. Jesus is the image of God.
Is he 100% God?
Listen to me, man. God is a spirit. I keep on telling you.
I didn't ask you about the spirit of him.
Listen,
is Jesus 100% God?
Listen, my answer. God is a spirit. So Jesus is 100% God, but not until he ascends back to his Father, where he's now become the representative of God, who we cannot see.
Oh, you mean after resurrection?
That's right.
So before resurrection.
See, I like this guy. We're getting somewhere.
No, wait. I understand, it's not a very complex thing.
I like this guy.
So you're saying, so you're telling me Jesus only after his resurrection
get full back
became fully God.
Yes.
Before that
he's still under the servant.
Was he 0% God?
No, servant.
Which means 0% God, right?
No, I wouldn't say 0% God.
But you can't be master and servant at the same time.
No.
You're either servant or the master.
No. He had his power but have it under control.
Forget control.
Was he a servant? You can have a great man. Hold on. You can have a great man, who have a lot of wealth. But he decide to be a servant in his own house. Possible.
Okay, does he? When he's a servant.
It's simple.
Very simple, isn't it? So the master decided to be the servant.
Okay. Yeah, that's right.
When somebody asks him, are you the master? What will he reply?
I am.
No. That example you gave me of a master who's behaving like a servant.
Right.
If somebody asked him and asked him to answer the truth, are you the master? What will that man answer?
I would say. He would say, I've been with you so long and you don't know me.
What will
I
ask?
Am the master.
All he asks you, are you the master?
What will he say? I am the master.
Okay, so if he's the master, then the question is this.
Huh?
Is Jesus, when he was the master,
right?
Was he master when he was on earth?
To a degree, that's what I'm trying
to say.
What I mean? To you.
You know what he wants to do?
He wants Jesus
to behave like a servant and a master. He wants you to have his cake and eat it.
My friend.
The reason the Christians keep doing this is because they cannot get their head around the fact that Jesus cannot be God and man at the same time.
My friend.
The only confusion they are in this place is because they believe he's man and God at the same time.
My friend.
Which is an oxymoron.